Hi, in this presentation I will show you how to quickly get started with Mainflux IoT platform. I will download the Mainflux from its GitHub repo, execute the make run command, which will start the Docker compose. Docker compose will pull Mainflux images from the Docker hub and start the Mainflux instance. We will then use Mainflux CLI to create users, things and channels, and connect things to channels so they can communicate. Mainflux internally uses NATs for messaging, and it exposes a series of adapters which publishers and consumers can connect to. Those adapters are mqtt, mqtts, http and https, ws and wss, and coap. I will show you examples of HTTP and MQTT communication after that. The machine I'm using here is just plain Ubuntu 18.10 and only has make, Docker and Docker compose installed on it. Additionally, for demonstration purposes, I also installed mosquitto clients so I can use mosquitto pub and mosquitto sub to send and receive some messages. So let's start. First thing we need to do, we need to clone the Mainflux code locally. So this is the Mainflux GitHub repo, and we will copy the link, and then we will go to this blue window, which will we will use this blue window for Mainflux IoT platform. So we do git clone, and it starts pulling the code. Once we have code inside, we just go in the directory and execute make run command. Make run command will start Docker compose, and Docker compose will start pulling all the images from Docker hub that we need, and then it will start it. So let's wait for a little bit. Okay, so it pulled all the images and started the containers, and now you can see some logs coming out of Mainflux. So now that we have this Mainflux instance up and running here, we need a way to configure it. So Mainflux exposes the API, so you can add new users, new things and channels. But One handy way to do it is to use Mainflux CLI. So in order to use Mainflux CLI, we need to download it from the Mainflux GitHub repo. So if you go to releases, you will see that there's a CLI here, and let's download it. So in this black window, we will use CLI to create users, channels and things. So let's download it first. Okay, it's here. Let's unpack it. So now we can start using it. Let's create a first user. So if it goes CLI, if you go just like this without any parameters, you will get the help and you will see all available commands like you know, channels and things and users, and also if you go like this, channels, users, you will get the format of command that you need to use. So in this case you can use channel users and then either create for create user or token to get a user token, and then you need to provide user email and password. So let's create one user. And here you see that, you know, the user is created, and if you follow the left side and the logs, you can see that post request to slash users is executed and the user is created. So now we have one user. What else we can do? We can get a token for that user, since we need token for all operations later on that user will do. So if that user needs to create a channel or a thing, the user needs to supply the token. So let's get a token. Okay, again you will see on the left side that there's a post request to tokens endpoint, and here's our token. So we will use this token with all following commands in order to create things and channels for this user. So all things and users creation, all things and channels creation commands need to have this token supplied. If I go like this, you will see that I need this token as the last parameter. So in order to make things simpler, I will put this user token in environmental variable. So let's do it like this. Okay, so now we have it in a variable. And if we want to create a thing, as you can see, we need to specify a JSON for that thing, and JSON is basically a type of a thing and name of a thing. So let's do it like this, CLI create, and then type will be device, and name will be testing. So that this is the JSON that that we need to create the device, and then we need to supply the user token. So now if we hit enter again on the left side, you will see that, you know, the thing service added the thing, so created a new thing, and also the nginx, which acts as a proxy, a reverse proxy in front of all the services, also registered the post request to things, and we have the success, and the response is basically the ID of a thing that has been created. So now we have one thing created. Similarly, we can create another thing, and this time let's create an app. Let's imagine that app and device will communicate in the future. So this time we will create the app, and you see we created the second thing. So this one has ID number 2, and on the left side you can also see things going on. So now we have two things. Let's see what we can find out about those things. So if you go like this, get one. So now we will request the thing. Again, we need to supply the user token because it's our thing. And we will get all the parameters, all the data about the first thing we created. So we will get the thing ID, we will get the thing type, we will get the name, and one important thing, we will get the token. So we need this token in order to be able to connect this thing to a channel. But first we need to have a channel. So let's create one channel so this thing and this application can communicate. So we go CLI channels, create, and then again we need to supply JSON for this channel, and JSON has one parameter which is name. And we need user token. So as you can see, it went successful, and the method create channel is called on the thing service. So now we have one channel, and the same way we did, we got information about the thing, we can also get information about the channel. So we go will get the information about this channel. So now we have two things. One is of type device, another is of type application here, and we have one channel. So let's connect those two things over this channel. So we go like this, let me just show you like this. So if you type this part of the command, it will show you the usage. So it will show you that first you need to specify the thing ID and then the channel ID, and you know that you need to supply the user token. So we first need to supply thing ID, which is one, then channel ID, which is also one, and then user token. Okay. Method connect, so basically we connected, you can see on the left side, and the response is okay. So we connected the thing, the first thing, which is device, to the channel. So now let's connect the second thing, which is the application. So in this case the thing ID is number two and the channel ID remains the same, so it's number one, and then user token. So if we do this, we now have thing number two with ID number two connected to the same channel. So now we have everything created in Mainflux in order to start using it. So let's say, for example, in this gray window, we can use mosquitto sub. For example, this device will subscribe to this channel and listen to it. So mosquitto sub, username is one, ID of the thing. Oh, sorry, I forgot one thing. So first we need this thing token. So let's export it the same way we did with user token. So let's export thing token. Okay, for the first device, for the first thing, it was like so things get one. Okay, so this is the token we need, so we will export it here, and now we can use it like this. Mosquitto sub, username one, password think token, channel name of the topic for channel number one is channels slash one slash messages, and we hit enter, And now on the upper left corner, the blue one, we can see that we have subscription. So basically, we see that this client subscribe to this topic. Okay, so now this one is up and listening. On the right side, we can do mosquitto pub, for example, but let's first export the token. So let's see the thing with ID 2 has this token. So like this, and now we can do mosquitto pub to password think token. Topic. And some message. For example, so you can see I published here successfully and the subscriber received it, and also you can see mqtt messages coming through. And one more thing is that this Mainflux normalizer, which complains because the Mainflux normalizer expects the messages in SendML format, because it can normalize these messages if the messages are in SendML format. So what we can do, I have one SendML message prepared, so I can show you how normalizer works. And let me show you. It looks like this. So basically a SendML message with two readings, and if we pass this through Mainflux, the normalizer will basically unfold, split those messages into two messages. So for this example, we can use curl. So instead of MQTT, we can use HTTP adapter. So if we do curl and then X post header, and we need think token here. And yes, HTTP localhost HTTP as adapter, that's the endpoint, and then channels one messages. So you see that the format is the same like for the MQTT topic. And then if we go like this, so we will basically send this SNML message which is stored in this file. If we hit enter, you will see on the left side that we received this SNML message, but also we can see that now the normalizer went fine, and then it took this much time to complete without errors. So yes, so as you can see, we also have metrics here, so all the operations have time measurements and things. So these were the two examples of MQTT and HTTP communications. Besides that, also coap and WebSockets communication is possible.